Hi everybody, I'm Bill Sanders and this is Watch Art Sci, the Art and Science Watch Collection. Today's Vest Pocket video is going to take a look at Stefan Kudicke, who is a master watchmaker in Germany. I believe the precise location is somewhere around Dresden, but I'm not positive about that. Anyway, Stefan is an AHCI candidate, which is sort of the elite independents belong to that. Just this last 2019 Grand Prix d'Horlogerie de Genève, he won the Petit Aiguille Award. And he's handmade watches. That's what he does. And so let's take a look at some of the watches that Stefan makes. He has really three collections. The first one is called the Handwerk Collection. Probably mispronouncing that. And he's got a couple of watches here. Now, these prices are the ones in for U.S. prices. There are other prices that involve VAT and everything else, so I'm not going to get into that. The two basic watches he's got is called the Kudicke 1 and Kudicke 2. The one on the left was the first one that he used is caliber 1 in. A caliber 1, you can see at the bottom, it's manual winding, winding watch, 46 hours of charge to it, and it's finished with a frosted and a gilded plate with a raised hand and a balance cock. By the way, this is similar to the one that Rolf Lang Dresden has in terms of, it's a German way of finishing in a very nice way. Now, the first one is simply time in small seconds over at 9 o'clock. The second one, the Kudicke 2, is the same. It has the same movement, except it's set up very differently. At the 12 o'clock, there's a day-night indicator, and that goes around, and it's either after nighttime or after morning, and so you see that at the top up there. I really like that watch. I came very close to buying it. Ended up with something else, but still just really fantastic. Now, we're talking about a handmade watch, and so these are not going to be rolling off of anybody's assembly line ever. And the Caliber 1 is very clean, very simple kind of thing. I think that Kudicke did some work with Richard Habring. I'm not positive about that. He also worked for some of the major watchmakers, too, before he decided to go out on his own. Now, this next group of watches, there's a lot of them. I mean, this is just a very small sample. Now, none of these use the Kudicke manufactured movement. They all use some other movement. Some are hand-wound, some are automatic. But the work that he does on the movements themselves in terms of decorations and engravings and with every aspect of it. The lower left down there is one example of what the backs of these watches look like. Now, the fronts, they're works of art themselves. The lower right down there is one called the Golden Dragon, and all of this is hand done. And these watches run around $8,000, $9,000, $10,000. They're not cheap at all. And like I said, you know, people who want something that's hand done, really special, these are the watches. The White Flower, these are just a sample. There's tons of all of these different designs that he has, and like I said, this is just a small sample of them. Now, one of the more interesting ones to me is called Mysticism. Right up around, I guess it'd be about 2 o'clock, 1:30, 2 o'clock, you can see a little dark blue triangle. This is on the Mysticism, is in the upper left corner up there. And that's the hour hand. And then the minute hand that goes around is that sort of a serpentine shape, and it's like super interesting watch. All of these are there are a lot of different designs, and I think that these are very artistic looking, but very different, very unique. So if you're interested in this, I tell you, Kudake is, I think he's a young designer, is that sometime later that you won't be able to get them for the same price. Let me put it that way. Okay, well, I'd really like to know what you have, what you think about these. And until next time, this is Bill Sanders for Watch Art Side, the art and science of Watts Collection.